Dana Sparks, broker of Maximum One Greater Atlanta Realtors. And this week's contract tip has to do with initials on a purchase and sale agreement. So if you have been practicing in Georgia for a while, you remember a time when on the front page of the contract, there was no place for the buyer or the seller to initial. And many agents had a concern on the front page. That's where the majority of the financial information is disclosed: sale price, seller's contribution to closing costs, so forth and so on. And so a lot of agents were concerned that that front page was never initialed by the parties, by the buyer and the seller. So the GAR Forms Committee, the Georgia Association of Realtors Forms Committee, did add at the bottom of page one of the GAR contract a place for the buyer and the seller to initial page one. If you are using, or if you go binding, or if you look at the RE Forms contract purchase and sale agreement, you will notice that at the bottom of every page, there is a place for the buyer and the seller to initial. And in the RE Forms contract on page one, where the purchase price is negotiated, there is also a place on the RE Forms contract for the buyer and the seller's actual name on that contract. So the question comes back to initials. So GAR Forms Committee, again, put a place for the initials on the bottom of page one. And as you all know, there is a signature page at the end of the purchase and sale agreement where the buyer and the seller sign the entire purchase and sale agreement. Obviously, the buyer signs it at point of offer, and when the parties go binding, they are either signing the purchase and sale agreement or the counteroffer form, which references the purchase and sale agreement. So back to the original topic, initials. Well, what do you do if the parties don't initial page one, don't initial the bottom of all the pages in the RE Forms contract, or more concerning is what happens if only one of the parties, the buyer or the seller, initials page one in the GAR contract or everything in the RE Forms, and the other party doesn't initial? Well, do you have an enforceable contract? Do you have a voidable contract? Do you have a valid contract? All the legal effects of the contract, are they in play or not? Well, here's the answer. The answer is Georgia law does not require initialing. Therefore, if the contract is valid and enforceable without the party's initials. So the parties do not have to initial for it to be valid and enforceable. That's not the issue. It's preferred, however, that both parties do initial where there is a place for the initial line. The issue is, well, what happens if one party initials and the other doesn't? Then you potentially have a controversy over, did one of the parties see page one or switch out page one or any of the other pages that were not initialed by both parties? If you, I address part of this issue in a previous video I've done on sending and receiving contract packages, so make sure to take a look at that. But bottom line is this, when you have a buyer and a seller that sign the contract at the end or counteroffer, then if you look at the bottom, it does specifically say page one of seven, page two of seven. And on that signature page in the GAR form, it says page seven of seven. And in the counteroffer form, it says page two of two. Therefore, if you have buyer and seller signatures on that page, it encompasses the additional pages, page 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So again, please refer back to the other video I did, entire video on sending and receiving contract packages, because it does encompass this whole issue of preventing any controversy or question about one of the parties switching out one of the pages in the contract form. But bottom line is Georgia law for contracts for real property does not require parties to initial. Therefore, without parties' initials, It is still a valid and enforceable contract. Point of practice to you as an agent, go ahead and get your parties to initial anywhere in any of the forms where it does require a place for an initial, and especially on page one, where now the GAR Forms Committee did see, did believe it was important to put that initial space at the bottom, and the RE Forms Committee does have an initial space at the bottom of every page. If you get back a contract and the other party has not initialed and your party has initialed, please make sure to, if you're still negotiating, make sure to get those initials. If you are already binding, I would do an amendment just requesting that the parties recognize that page one is page one of the contract, or better yet, you can do, if you went binding on a counteroffer form, then you can request and perform a conformed copy. Remember, if you do a conformed copy, to use that special stipulation that does state that it is a conformed copy, and if there were any typographical errors, that the original binding, terms of the original binding do prevail. And that is provided for you also in the GAR Special Stipulations Library. So short and sweet today, but hope this contract tip did help you on initialing purchase and sale agreements for real property in the state of Georgia. Thank you so much for watching. Dana Sparks, broker of Maximum One Greater Atlanta Realtors, satisfying your needs with service, innovation, and education.